Hi, Dina.
Hi, Martin. What's up?
In a previous episode, you showed me your checklist for porting containerized web apps to Cloud Run. And by running them serverlessly on Cloud Run, I got autoscaling, I only pay when my code is running, and I don't have to do server maintenance.
Actually, I believe I showed you two checklists.
Oh, right. The first checklist for finding out if my containerized app can be ported to Cloud Run. And it said that the container should be stateless.
That's right.
And then in the comments, a viewer asked how to port containerized web apps that store and use sessions. In other words, apps that are stateful on the server.
Okay, well, those containers can still be ported to Cloud Run, but it does require a few more steps. Let me show you how.
All right, I have this e-commerce web app that keeps track of the user's shopping cart contents between requests, and it does so with server-side sessions. For example, if I reload the page like this, the session is still active, so the shopping cart content is still there.
I see. Yeah, that does make the container stateful. Anytime your application reads and writes data locally, for instance, to a database or a key value store, this means that your application is stateful. And that's just a way of saying that you're saving the state locally. But let's focus on the user sessions right now.
Yeah. Why do we even need to think about statefulness, Dina?
Okay, here's the deal. If your server-side code stores user session data in memory, it's easy to lose it.
Why is that?
Well, for instance, your server may crash, which wipes out its memory. Also, if you're running your app on a serverless platform, like Cloud Run, each user request is sent to the next available instance, which may not be the instance that has the user session in memory.
Oh, that sounds like a huge problem.
Yeah, exactly. So, try not to store sessions in the server's memory.
Okay, but I've got to store the session data between requests somewhere.
Yes, store it outside the server. For instance, Redis is an open source distributed key value store, and it is a great alternative to saving locally because it's fast and it can still be reached by your application servers.
Okay, but my app uses the Express framework with the Express session package, and that package stores session data in memory on the server.
You're right, it does by default, but you can edit it. You can add a Redis connector to it. Many frameworks like Express, Django, Flask, Laravel, Spring Boot, Koa, Gin, and Ruby on Rails can be configured to use Redis for session storage.
Okay, let me go and read the docs for Express session and see if I can connect it to Redis. Let's meet back here for a little bit.
Sounds good. I will grab a cup of tea.
All right, I'm back, Dina. I added the Redis connector to my app. It requires the address of a Redis server and the port it listens to. So my code now reads those values from environment variables.
Well done. Okay, so let's set up your Redis server. Go to the Cloud Console, open the hamburger menu, and click Memory Store. Memory Store is Google's hosted solution for Redis, which automates many important features like high availability and patching.
Okay, I will pick Redis for now, and I'm enabling Memory Store in this project.
Good, okay, now click Create Instance. Give it a name and a display name. For the rest of the fields, the defaults are fine. Now click Create. Now your Redis server is being initialized. This server sits in a virtual private cloud, so it's not accessible from the public internet. So next, we need to set up a connector so that your Cloud Run service can connect to your virtual private cloud. To do that, first pick VPC network in the navigation sidebar. Then click serverless VPC access. Click create connector and give it the name my VPC connector. Under network, pick default. Under subnet, pick custom IP range. And go ahead and enter that suggested 10.8.0.0 in the IP text box. And click create. Okay, now head back over to the memory store and copy the IP address of the Redis instance that you just created. In your deployment shell script, add Redis host, Redis port, and VPC connector as environment variables.
Okay, now that is done. I will build and deploy the container.
Is it working?
Let's see. Let me reload the page here. Refresh. Yeah, it's working.
Okay, awesome. Let's recap what you have achieved. By moving your container to Cloud Run, you no longer need to maintain a server. And your service auto scales as load increases. And we have Cloud Run to thank for this. Now, Cloud Run is able to offer these features by not storing the data in memory. So, by putting the session data in Redis via memory store, you won't lose it if the user's second request hits a different server than their first request, or if an app server crashes.
I like that. Have we earned another tea break, Dina?
I think so.
Thank you all for watching. If you have any questions for Dina or me, enter them in the comments below and we'll try to answer them. Also, let us know what other serverless topics we should bring up in this video series. Bye for now.